In this video, I'm going to show you how to create this basic animation to your diagrams using After Effects. So as many of you know, creating diagrams nowadays is getting easier, and making them impactful and eye-catching can be difficult sometimes. So one way I've found your diagrams can make more impact and in general explain more complex ideas in a shorter amount of time is by animating them. So let's take the diagram we're going to animate as an example. I can show you these static images side by side and explain what they each mean and probably do a good job. But on the other hand, I could animate this and tell you a story, make it entertaining, show complex ideas, complex forms, and you as the viewer can understand much faster how this building came to life with just one animation. So in order to make this animation, I need to master a couple of animation techniques that will explain different parts of the process. Explaining all of these concepts in one video will take me some time, so I'll show you how to create these two first, the outline and the push. Now, if you have seen animated diagrams before, you know this is the staple move you need to learn to explain some basic concepts. In our case, we will use these two moves to show the perimeter and area of our site and show how a main volume extrudes from that area. Now let's start animating our diagram. But quickly before we start, I want to show you that this is an extract from our most recent course, Animated Diagrams. There, we learn different types of animations you can apply to your diagrams in an easy and impactful way. We show you the basics of storyboarding and explain the project. And if you're a complete noob to After Effects, don't worry, this course is beginner friendly and we will teach you the ins and outs of the software for architects. So if you're interested in learning how to transform your drawings, check out the course in the link in the description. Now let's start. So let's open After Effects and create a new composition. Here I want a composition that is similar to the size of my screen, so I'll use 1920 by 1080, but if you want to create an animation to create a reel or send through your phone, you can use this composition size. For the duration of our animation, we're going to put 10 seconds in our timer. Now I'm going to import the base image of my context. This is an image that I exported first from SketchUp, adjusted the line weight, imported onto Photoshop, and added some nice patterns and textures. If you want a tutorial on how to create these types of images, let me know in the comment section. Now I'll drag this onto my composition. Using the shift key and dragging from one corner, I'll resize the image. Next, we're going to create our site outline. For this, I'll select the pen tool in this top bar. I'll make sure the fill is non-existent and the stroke is around 3 pixels wide. I'll modify the color of the outline to match the color of my drawing using the eyedrop tool. Now, I'll draw the outline as precise as possible. After this is done, I'll click on the drop-down arrow on my shape layer, click on the arrow next to add, and select trim paths. I'll open the trim path drop-down menu, make sure my time indicator is at the beginning, and I will click on the stopwatch next to end. Now I'll drag the percent indicator all the way to zero. So as you can see, our stroke passed from being complete to now being non-existent. Next, I'll move my time indicator to the 1 second mark, and I'll place the percentage of our end indicator all the way in 100. If we press play, we can see how our animation comes to life. Also, you can move and drag these keyframes closer to each other for a faster animation or farther away for a slower one. To make this animation much smoother, we're going to select our keyframes and press F9. This will make our animation smooth and elegant. Now, I forgot to configure one thing on my line. I'll open the shape menu, open the stroke menu, and add a dash. Here, as you can see, our line will appear dashed. Next, I'll add my highlight effect, which will basically fill my site area with a color for a second and then put it transparent again. So this will be really easy. I'll just open the fill menu on my shape layer, turn on the layer by selecting the eye right here. Next, I'll go to the 1 second mark and click on the stopwatch next to opacity. I'll make sure the opacity here is zero. I'll move my time indicator to the 1.5 second mark and put the opacity in 100%. I'll also select the color rectangle and add the color of my choice. Next, I'll move on to the 2 second mark and put the opacity in zero. I'll select all of my keyframes again and press F9 to make them buttery smooth. So if I press play, you can see how our animation is turning out. Now let's jump onto our second animation style, the push movement. Here, we can use the same shape we created, but just so we don't get confused, I'll duplicate the shape and erase the keyframes. To duplicate, just select the shape layer and press Ctrl D. To see all the keyframes we created, you can just press the letter U on your keyboard and you will see how they appear. I'm going to select all these keyframes and press delete. Next, I'm going to drag my second layer to the 3 second mark, which is when our push animation will begin. To not get confused, I'm going to name my first layer Sight Outline and then my second layer Push Animation. Now we can do this in two different ways. The first way is to export your base images from SketchUp as PDFs, import them to Illustrator, and adjust the line width and erase unnecessary layers. Then we can import our shape as an Illustrator file, convert our file to shapes, and animate those shapes. Our second way is to draw those shapes directly within After Effects. Now for this video, I'm gonna draw the shape layers inside of After Effects, but if you want to learn the different techniques, you can sign up to our Animated Diagrams course to learn how to do them. So for now, I'm going to first make sure the fill of my push layer is white and that my stroke is normal, not dashed, just like this. Next, I'm going to drag my shape up, but first I'll keep the shift key selected to drag it in a straight line. So as soon as I have it in place, I'm going to create the other two faces of the volume. I'm going to draw each shape on the same layer, so make sure you have the layer selected before you start drawing it. Then I'm going to select my pen tool, make sure the stroke and width and color are the same, and I'll draw the first face of my rectangle. Try to make it as precise as possible. I'll make sure my layer is selected again and now go to the pen tool again and draw the other face of the rectangle, just like this. And just so we don't accidentally select our background layer or area layer, I'm going to lock both layers. Now I'll select my layer and type into the search bar of the layer tab the word path. I'll drag my time indicator to the 5 second mark and click on the stopwatch next to the path option. Now I'll go back to my 3 second mark, place the time indicator, and having the path selected as well, I'll select only the paths from the top part of my cube. So I'll select this one, and having Control and Shift selected, I'll select the other three. As soon as I have all of them selected, I'll select this top corner and drag it down until it meets the bottom of the cube. And if I press spacebar and play the animation, you can see how we just created this push out animation in a very easy way. Now, before we finish this animation, I just want to remind you that our Animated Diagrams course has around 32 lessons, 3 hours of content, bonus resources, certificate of completion, and lifetime access. And if you want to learn different techniques like these in an easy to understand way, you can click the link in the description or visit our website for more info. Now, to finish off this animation, I'm going to first activate the motion blur. I'll select all of my layers and make sure this option is turned on in all of my layers. This is how it looks without motion blur, and this is with motion blur. Then I'm going to grab all of my layers and place them in a group. Make sure you unlock all your layers. I'm going to select all of them and click on pre-compose and now press OK. Now having my layer selected, I'm going to press S on my keyboard for scale. I'm going to click on the stopwatch and change the scale to 115. Now I'm going to go to the end of my animation and put the scale in 100. This is how our animation looks like now. Now to export, I'm going to go to composition, add to render queue, and in output, I'm going to select the specific folder and click on render. I'll wait a few seconds for it to export and that's it. We have our animation. So this is how the animation looks like after I added a few more effects. As you can see, it breaks down the main problems and design solutions of the building and explains them in a simple and understandable manner. Now, if you want to see more videos on how to animate your drawings, comment down below. I'll catch you in the next video. Bye.